guys, welcome back to another awesome video. My name is Nox, as in N-O-K-S. Hola, Peniscula, and I'm back again with another awesome video. And guys, don't mind my book. And if I keep looking down, you must just know that I'm referring to my notes that I've made so that I don't miss anything. Okay, one of the questions as well when it comes to mental health and employment is, should you then maybe disclose your mental health status if you've been diagnosed before, if you're looking for a job, if you're already working? Is it safe to maybe talk about those things or disclose where you are with your mental health? I don't have a straight answer, but if you are maybe in human resources or you are at a managerial position or you are dealing with people, please do use the comment section in terms of what would you do or what would you advise. Otherwise, the views that I'm sharing because I know exactly what happens out there in the workplace. I'm fully aware of the background and everything that happens in the background. And one of the reasons most people would not, number one, be open or maybe disclose their mental health or statuses when it's related to the workplace, especially when you are still looking for a job. And when it says, some people will say mental health, they will then put a status there, is that you are thinking, should I then disclose that maybe I'm diagnosed with this mental health? They will then not consider your application, or they know the client or the company knows that they do not have any support system to actually help you with your mental health, and you might feel or you might be discriminated. And we need to be very honest about these things. A lot of times when it comes to the process of being employed, there's a lot of discrimination that happens. We all know we get discriminated because of our race, our age, our sexual orientation, whatever the case is. And the sad part about this thing is, when they do discriminate, they won't come back to you and say, the reason why we did not consider your CV is because you've got this mental health. They know that the law does not support. And according to the Employment Act, you can't discriminate someone because of their mental health or sexual orientation or their race or gender. So we all know that they will not come forward and say those things. So when you do disclose, you must just be ready. One of the reasons people tend to judge, okay, is because people are not, do I say learned, or they're not clued up, or they don't have as much information of what it means, and they will tend to judge you that you will not be able to perform your duties, right? If I come up front and say I've got anxiety, my boss could be thinking, this one is trouble most. If I hire her, she will take 5 days off. She would not perform her duties. I would have to follow up with her. I would have to ask her. Her reports would have a lot of errors and things like that, which is not true, right? But people don't know those things, so people don't then disclose because they don't know how they're going to get treated. Another thing to consider when you do disclose is to know exactly if there is support. I know some companies will do partnership with employment or workplace wellness centers, where if one of their employees is going through mental health issues, they can then extend a hand and refer. Some companies that are well off, like very big, structured, nicely organized companies, they do have a department which deals with the psychological matters where you can go seek help. And another thing is, when I speak of support, sometimes human resources, we are thinking human resources is for the people. No, most of the time that's not the case. And people in human resources tend to talk too much, right? They share information and people don't feel there's a room to share, and other people not knowing. When you take your day off, when you go to HR and you ask for a leave day, sometimes they tend to ask a lot of questions and you feel, I'm not yet as comfortable to actually open up. Why am I doing those things? So that becomes a problem again. Should you then be diagnosed with a mental health illness while working, not when you're looking for a job? Do you then run to your boss or run to the relevant person and actually report this is what you are going through? Another thing, guys, is being judged all the time. Simply because people, like I said before, people don't have as much information about it. And we all don't like to be judged. That's why we sit in the corner and we try to absorb as much as we can. And when we struggle, we never feel like the platform is allowing us to actually talk about those things. Because number one, they will say you are nagging, you are complaining too much, all these things that are negative. So you then decide to keep quiet. So at the end of the day, all that matters is your well-being, okay? And if you feel maybe at work, you know that there's no room and you would not get support. Instead of getting support, you will feel like, I mean, I should have just, you know, not disclosed these things. And maybe do that because your well-being is very important before the work. So if the workplace doesn't offer that support space where you are able to share these things, maybe don't share and go look for help. There are organizations out there that are now starting to help and assist, and just seek help, you know, ask around and go to Google on the internet and check, and, you know, just make sure that you are doing something to actually help your situation. You can't fully rely on your workplace, even though we should start talking about these things, which are not easy. We should start encouraging organizations and bosses and anyone who's running a business to actually start investing or start making workspace a place where people can be comfortable and talk about mental health without feeling judged, and with full understanding that they can still perform their duties. Otherwise, don't forget to use the comment section. Like I said, please share your experiences. If you regret ever opening up about mental health, or if you know someone that did that and things went south for them to a point where the boss had to make sure that they get fired, or they make mistakes, or they were not supportive and not understanding what is mental health, because it still remains one of the reasons we are unhappy in the workplace, and people will forever be looking for jobs while not understanding that as a country, because I'm in South Africa, we are not yet at a stage where we really take a very good look in mental health while a lot of people are going through the most. And I'm not saying it's just junior people. You could have a boss that is very depressed and, you know, they just have a long face all the time. They're shouting at you. And some bosses do swear, and we tend to understand and say, I mean, she's just like that. Or this is what he does things. And we become understanding, and no one just looks and say, maybe this person needs help, and just give them a platform where they can open up so that they can then have a good focus when it comes to work. Otherwise, you know, you guys, I always want to give you awesome content. I know I just did. So do share this video. It might help someone. Someone might go through comment section and actually do get help, because people are going through the most. And let's not forget to be kind and to be nice to people, because we don't know what people are going through. I will see you guys on another awesome video.